What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. And today's topic is ACID. Not the kind that you take Nexium for, but the other kind, which is database ACID, which stands for atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. So this is applied. This is relevant for the relational databases. So let's discuss this. So let's break this. And what is ACID and why these properties? Why do we have these four properties and how they are useful for us, right? So if we're gonna start the databases word, the first property is atomicity. All right, so in order to discuss these properties, we're going to take, like we always do in this channel, an example, an actual real-life example, not a hello world example, right? So let's take Instagram for an example here, right? Let's assume this is all made up, obviously, the design and everything is going to be made up. But let's take Instagram for example, and let's assume that we're going to design the database for Instagram. So you're going to build an ERM for Instagram. So we'll take it very simple. So you have pictures, right? And you have people, which are users, and you have people liking pictures. Let's take the comments out of the picture here. So the requirements is, for each picture that I post, I need to know how many likes this picture makes, right? So that's one piece of information. The other piece is who likes these pictures. Who are they? Give me the list of all these users. So the way I'm gonna design this is, yeah, let's go ahead and create like two tables here. And I'm using this online tool, sketch.io. So it's a really cool app. I just found it. So yeah, so we're gonna make a table called pictures, and then we're gonna make another table called likes, which are the individual likes of these, right? And what do we have? That's big. All right. What do we have? We have an ID, a picture have an ID, correct? And what else? Picture has URL. Again, it's all fictional, right? So maybe they might have more and more and more stuff there, but. And we have likes counts, right? All right. And for consistency, make it all caps to follow the standard here. So that's URL, right? That sounds good, sounds good, sounds good. All right, how about the likes? So this will tell me, like, for this particular picture with this ID, right? This got this much. We're gonna get to examples in a second here. So let's just go ahead and make this smaller. Just copy that. A like will basically have the picture ID, right? Which picture got like, and literally who liked it. Does that make sense? I think it does, right? It's very simple. Yeah. Oh, I don't want that. It's just feels like a table, I guess, right? Think. Right. That makes sense. I'm gonna move my face here in a second. But yeah, makes sense, right? So, yeah, okay, so we'll discuss atomicity. So we talk a little time just to sketch up this stuff. So let's say I have, what? I just posted a new picture. I don't really care who posted. I mean, we can add that record, who is the owner of this picture, but it's not relevant for this. But we can add a lot of stuff. So it got an ID. So picture number one. Oh man, is this number one? All right. And it has some URL. And zero likes, okay? Got another hunter delete stuff in a second, but we have no likes for this picture. So let's discuss atomicity here. So that's we just have a nice design now. So we like that, right? So these are linked, right? So one picture can have many likes, I think. Yeah. Zero or more. Like that in this case. Yeah, so yeah, atomicity, the first thing, first property, right? So a whole thing was just to discuss that atomicity, and then we're gonna discuss in different videos the rest of properties of assets. So we have a database here. What is atomicity? What is that? So let's say my name is John Snow, and he found picture one, which is a picture of a wolf, I guess. He's into that, right? So he likes that picture. Double click, all right? Double tap, and he likes it. So how are we going to update? What is the series of SQL that we need to update, right? So what do we need to do? What series of SQL statements that we need to execute in order to update that? There are two things, right? First, the first statement is, hey, I'm liking picture number one. So two statements. The first one is update table pictures. Maybe we'll just write that as well. All right. Yeah, why not? Update. That's too big again. So update pictures set likes count equal likes count plus one, right? Where ID is equal one. I'm liking picture number one. So that's the first statement. Yeah, let's make it like that. Okay, let's make it a little smaller. So what is the second statement? The second statement is also add me, I am Joan, insert a record into the likes table. Insert into likes. Yeah, for simplicity, you just assume that John, right? All right, so these are the two statements that needs to be executed, okay? First, set that count, and then insert a record, okay? So what is atomicity? This brings us to the topic we need to discuss, which is atomicity, atomic. We need to make this unit of work that like has to happen as a one unit, single unit of work. That means if that statement get executed, all right, the other statement has to be executed. So both of them has to succeed. Otherwise, we will end up in an inconsistent state, right? So what will happen here is, hey, okay, I'm going to basically delete that puppy. Okay. And then, yeah, like one, right? And then I am going to actually add a new record here. Jeez, that handwriting though. John Snow, what are you doing, John? All right, look at that. So yeah, so I updated that record and I also inserted a new record here. So if something happened, like atomicity is this property. If I manage to successfully update that picture, and for some reason, let's say I lost connection, right? database went down at that moment. Really unlikely, but let's say that that's one case where the atomicity can kick in, right? And let's say I just lost connectivity. I lost connection to the database, so I did not manage to send that alert statement, which is really unlikely. But yeah, okay, so I end up with this, but I did not update, I did not insert a new record for John to the likes. So if that happened, let's assume that I don't have any atomicity, and Instagram might actually not have that. They don't really care. It says, it's not really, I don't care if it shows like you have 100 likes and if you list that. We're going to talk about that in a minute. But just let's say if you don't have atomicity and I did that, our picture will show one like. So I'm going to, using my app. That's supposed to be a phone. All right, so, I click on that, all right. That's John Snow. He just clicked on that and he liked it. And for some reason he lost connection, and then he come back and he say, that owner of the picture says, my wolf got one like. But if I click, I wanna see who actually liked it, right? I wanna see who liked it. So you click on that, and you'll end up, it says, no users. That's an example of inconsistent results that you get out of not implementing atomicity. So atomic transaction. So these two pieces of SQL statement has to be executed together. And that's why you have to wrap it in a transaction. If you're doing programming, you have to, both those puppies have to go in. If one of them failed, that's one case of failure where you lost connection, right? But you're going to end up with a lot of other failures. Constraint, which we'll see in the next episode. You're going to see a lot of cases. So that's, in a nutshell, that is atomicity. So let's do another thing. The same Sansa, right? So that beautiful wolf, and she decided to like that picture too. Says, we're doing Sansa. Let's go. Okay, delete. Okay, this is ridiculous. All right. So now Sansa liked that picture. So two statements. It is two, right? And then Sansa. Jesus. What are you doing, Sansa? Look at that picture. All right, so we have now two, right? Now, we're going to discuss the consistency in the next episode. So that's the second property. So that's basically atomicity, right? If you don't end up, so atomicity and consistency are kind of linked, but I prefer to discuss it in a previous episode. So you might have a lot of questions about primary keys and foreign keys. We're going to discuss that in the next episode. So stay tuned, guys. Subscribe. And we're going to see you on the next one. IGM Tree, Software Engineering by Examples. See you.